Thank you. Noah Evan. I teach saxophone here. Thank you for being here. We're really looking forward to playing for you this evening. We are going to be playing Variations on America by Charles Ives. It was written originally for organ in 1891 when Ives was just 17 years old. It consists of five variations of the familiar tune America with two bitonal interludes. And that means that the group will be playing in two different key signatures. So you'll hear that clashing kind of dissonance, which is what Ives, one of the things Ives was known for, which was an innovative compositional technique back in his day. And this arrangement was made by Paul Cohen, who teaches saxophone at Rutgers University and Manhattan School of Music. And he used the original organ composition to create this arrangement, even though there already existed an orchestral arrangement and other arrangements of the piece. So I hope you enjoy Variations on America.
Thank you.
Sitting on stage in front of you is the Rowan University Concert Band, which is about a 70-person ensemble comprised of both music majors of all varieties, there's lots of different kinds, and musicians who are majoring in academic areas outside of music. Tonight's concert title is called Sound Palette. Throughout tonight's musical selections, we try to capture an auditory landscape similar to a painter holding a painter's palette standing in front of a blank canvas. Painter Jean-Michel Basquiat said that art is how we decorate space and music is how we decorate time. Tonight's concert selections were chosen for their wide variety of color, shapes, hues, tactile sensations, and movement. For some people, when they hear music or sounds, they experience the sound itself, but they also experience all of those other sensations simultaneously. I'm one of those people. There's lots of other people out there who experience music similarly. It's almost like every sound or piece of music is a fully immersive experience in and of itself. Painter Henri Matisse said that, "When I started to paint, I felt transported into a kind of paradise. In everyday life, I was usually bored and vexed. Starting to paint, I felt gloriously free." In this concert, we will try our best to invite you to experience each piece as its own miniature, fully immersive universe. So our first selection for you tonight is called Shortcut Home by Dana Wilson. So please enjoy Shortcut Home. Next piece is titled Night Dances by Bruce Shirko. Mr. Yurko is from New Jersey, and he served as adjunct faculty, composition faculty here at Rowan University for many, many years. He, in fact, was here when I was a student, and he's actually in the audience with us tonight. One of his most frequently performed pieces within the wind band repertoire is our next piece. Nighttime has such an interesting aesthetic. It has an unexplainable feeling. It has its own color palette, its own lighting scheme and sounds. It's a whole other world that some people prefer to daytime. Vincent van Gogh has stated, quote, "I often think that night is more alive and more richly colored than day." So we hope you enjoy Night Dances.
Thank you.
awesome. Famous American astronomer and planetary scientist Carl Sagan said the following when describing outer space. He said, quote, "There is a wide, yawning, black infinity in every direction, and extension is endless. The sensation of depth is overwhelming, and darkness is immortal. Where light does exist, it is pure and blazing and fierce. But light exists almost nowhere, and the blackness itself is also pure, blazing, and fierce." This next piece is titled Celestial Body by living composer Robert Langenfeld. I discovered this work by accident. The composition caught my attention because the piece overall feels like it goes nowhere and everywhere all at once, which, if we're focusing on musical shapes, colors, and movement, that's quite a challenging feat as a composer. The composer achieves this by utilizing compositional techniques closely aligned with something called shepherd tones and shepherd scales. A shepherd tone or shepherd scale creates the auditory illusion of a tone or scale that continually ascends or descends in pitch, which ultimately actually doesn't get any higher or lower. It's kind of like a musical optical illusion. This piece was written in dedication to souls that we've lost on this earth, and our composer says, may their souls become a part of the great celestial body. So please enjoy Celestial Body. like up here for me. That piece is it. Woo! It's a good place to be. All right. Composer Olivier Messiaen has many times been studied and interviewed regarding his ability to associate sound with visual representations. He said, quote, "In fact, when I hear or read music, I always see color complexes in my mind that go with the sound complexes." Our next piece is titled Anthem by Stephen Bryant. Stephen Bryant has a very specific compositional language, and I think that this piece is a very good representation of how he writes and what tools he uses. The piece is called Anthem. It doesn't have much backstory other than it's based, his inspiration, and it's based around rock and roll music, what it's like to be at a rock concert, like the physical sensation, the smells, the sounds, what you see, what you hear, what you feel, taste, right? So rock concert, maybe a rave, if we've ever been in one of those. So yeah, please enjoy Stephen Bryant's Anthem.
Thank you.
appreciate your engagement with all of our musical offerings here at Rowan University. My name is Professor Megan Cooney. I am the Associate Director of Bands and Director of Athletic Bands here at Rowan. Our final piece this evening is by composer Percy Granger. Granger's contributions to our wind band repertoire are profound. While he was alive, he was such an interesting person. He too described his connection to music being beyond just the normal auditory experience. Percy Granger is known for his eccentric compositional approaches and eccentric personal behavior. We hope you enjoy tonight's concert. This last piece by Percy Granger is one of his most famous pieces, and it's performed probably the most, and it's been transcribed for the most genres and idioms and combinations of instruments. So please enjoy Country Gardens.